Hey, we're Audio Adrenaline. And you're watching The Zone.
That was good.
Hey, what's up? I'm Jenny, and I'm hanging out at Rcktwn in Nashville with my new friends, Audio Adrenaline. Woo-hoo! What's up, guys?
We're doing pretty good.
While hanging out with Audio Adrenaline today, we're going to be checking out some of their classic videos, as well as checking up with the guys, seeing what they've been doing since wrapping up their final tour together. And starting off, we're going to talk about the video Get Down.
It was Ben's idea to shoot this video.
Yeah,
really?
A lot of the videos were Ben's idea.
Really?
And you can be the judge. There's one part where I'm in a little scooter and these kids threw water balloons at me, but I'm fairly certain they might have put those water balloons in the freezer because they didn't feel like water balloons when they hit them. I mean, they hit them hard.
Oh, man.
Either that or the kids in California can throw a lot harder
than
I'm used to.
Red
welts.
Yeah.
It's like a giant.
It was a really fun video to make, and Darren Doan directed it. Yeah? He's done some like Blink 182 videos and some big videos, so it was pretty cool.
All right, well, here's Get Down on The Zone.
Lavishly, lives are wasted, humble, less is left, untasted. You can't live your life to please yourself.
All right, Mark and Will, I know you guys have done a lot of touring as speakers, so what do you speak about?
Now we work together with Hands and Feet, and we do speaking engagements. And one of the things we do together is a thing called AA Talks, where we go out and talk about our problems with alcohol.
Yeah.
Really?
No. And American Airlines.
I see that hand.
I see that hand out there.
No, it's AA Talks, unfortunately that's the name, but we go out and we talk about how it all got started and some of the struggles we went through and the stories behind Audio Adrenaline, encourage people really to live out, you know, the story that God has for them. Beginning of it, of Audio A, we were so young, we didn't really think about this was our God's calling.
Destiny or
something. Yeah, exactly.
Like, we were 10 years into it, like, wow, this was amazing. It was a gift from God. I think more than anything, we learned that God uses our shortcomings and weaknesses in Audio Adrenaline to glorify Himself. I think people, when they look at the church, they want to know that they're just like, you know, the people inside the church have issues.
Exactly.
You know, they're going through the same struggles that you're struggling with, and it's no different. It's not that they have some special sauce, it's just that they're getting help, you know, in church.
Right, exactly. That definitely ties into the next video. Coming up next on our classic video countdown, we have Underdog by Audio Adrenaline.
I am so weak and I'm so tired. It's life for me to find enough strength to feed us.
Welcome back to The Zone. Today we're hanging out with Grammy and Dove award-winning artist, Audio Adrenaline.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah. Well, I know one of your most popular songs was Hands and Feet, and then that just sort of like turned into this like huge organization. So tell me about Hands and Feet, what that project's about.
Actually, we were kind of going along in Audio Adrenaline. We would sing that song every night, you know, and really encourage kids to become the hands and feet of Christ. And,
right.
I think one day it just sort of clicked in our head that we needed to be more than just being a Christian rock band that toured all over the world, that we should actually do something as well. We had an awesome connection with Haiti because Mark's parents had been missionaries there on and off for 20 years. We sort of called them up and said, hey, we know you're in retirement, but we've got this crazy idea that we need to start an orphanage, a children's village down in Haiti, and would you want to come run it with us?
Uh-huh.
And they're like, ah, sure, you know. And so we went down there about 3 years ago and purchased the land, and then it's just been, you know, kind of crazy fast pace ever since. We have 34 beautiful children down there now that we're taking care of. Every one of them is just a miraculous story after a miraculous story, you know.
So, like, if some of our viewers really want to get involved, like, how do they find out more about Hands and Feet?
You can go to handsandfeetproject.org is the best way to check out how you can help. And there's all kinds of ways. You can go on a trip, like Will was talking about. We have a campus there where you can go and stay and actually see what it's like to be a missionary. Go love on babies, build stuff. It's amazing. Yeah. We have kids there and trips going in every week. We need Haiti as much as Haiti needs us because we're kind of duped into this idea as Americans that we can build our own safety net. You know, we can...
Right.
We can we can be sanitized and not be touched. You know, we can put away our money, but really, there's no security in life at all. Stuff can be stripped away from me at
exactly.
any time. And it's been a great journey. It all came out of that one song, you know, and that song really affected us as much as it affected the people that listened to it.
Appropriately, here's Hands and Feet on The Zone.
An image flashed across my TV screen. Another broken heart comes into view. I saw the pain and I turned my back.
Today we're hanging out at Rcktwn with Ben here, who's done a little different version of Hands and Feet. Tell me a little bit about like what Rcktwn is.
Rcktwn, this building started about 5 years ago. We're in downtown Nashville, just in the shadows of all the big skyscrapers and things like that. And we are just a facility set up to kind of give an image to these kids that have no idea who this Jesus person is. And we're here to just kind of be Jesus in their lives. And sometimes that's just taking them skateboarding or you know, doing things, having a cup of coffee with them. And then we have programs that they can get involved with. We use concerts and the skate park as an attraction for the kids.
Right.
And then once they're here, we have programs from like drum lessons and guitar lessons to Bible studies. So we pretty much just use the building as a tool and a way to get kids in with actual Christian staff and mentors and volunteers and things like that. But we're here to be kind of a bridge to the church, because the kids that come to Rcktwn basically aren't kids that would walk through a church.
Right.
And our goal and our aim is to get kids into Bible studies and to start thinking that maybe I need to learn more about this Jesus guy. And then hopefully we can kind of get them involved with churches.
A lot of it's really just about trust.
It's relationships
just be like,
and trust.
Here's a pamphlet. Yeah. You know, Jesus will change your life.
If we gave a kid a tract here, they would, you know, kind of walk away. But
yeah,
it's just the trust and the relationships that really builds up. And really, we're just trying to model that to kids.
Right. Yeah. Obviously, Rcktwn is a pretty cool place to experience. And we have a lot more really cool things for you to experience coming up next on The Zone. Hey, I'm Jenny, and you're watching The Zone, and I've been hanging out with Audio Adrenaline, counting down some of their classic videos, and it makes
classic.
You guys sound so old.
Classic
videos. Yeah. Let's talk about your next video, Some Kind of Zombie.
You know what? It actually came out of experiences from Haiti, too.
Yeah. Really?
Like real.
Yeah, that's true.
Crazy
yeah.
stuff in Haiti. But the idea that...
Don't tell them the idea. All Let's right. let them write in and tell us what they're... Because that's even better.
All right. Well, you write in your most creative ideas. Yeah.
And you forward them to us. Yeah.
Your interpretation of the video.
I really love...
The person that gets it right, if they email me, ben@rcktwn.org, I will send them a little care package.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, here is Some Kind of Zombie on The Zone.
I must have been
back to The Zone. We're wrapping today's show up with Audio Adrenaline.
Thank goodness.
Terrible.
I know. Pretty crappy host, but anyway. No, I'm just kidding. I'm great. Big House was so great. I know that's like your all's favorite song, and you listen in your car on the way.
Hold on. Is that
day.
What we're doing next? No, we can't. That's not cool.
You don't want to do
we
Big
are
House?
Kind of sick
we're so
of
over
the
that.
Song Big House.
I'm
How about 20s? If we'll show a little bit?
All right. Well, here's your 10-second snippet of Big House.
Can we show a video we want to show?
Yeah. What video would you rather show?
There you go.
One of our favorites.
Okay, what would
All
that be?
All-time classics. This is
our second biggest hit.
It's really a cool theme. It's about there's nothing that you can do in your life that ever separate you from Christ. In fact, the junk in your life that you think keeps you away from God, He can forgive you. And actually not only forgive you, but forget it. And you're completely clean again, which is cool. Something great about the gospel. And He throws all the junk in your life into the very bottom of the ocean, which is a miracle.